Hi, Dante here with Juan McLean, and I have another tech tip video. Today I'm standing here with an AquaBalance series of boiler. Of course, our AquaBalance comes in heat only and combi versions. One of the very nice features that we've put into our boiler manual is what we call the quick start guide. So let's go ahead and take a look. When we initially power up the boiler, it's a 6-foot power cord that comes with that boiler. When you plug it into its own separate circuit, into a GFI, couple of things can happen. Number one, if you get an A16, A is an apple, 16, what that's telling us is there is no outdoor temperature sensor connected to the boiler. So if it's a heating application, heating boiler, you must have an outdoor temperature sensor connected to that. So bring the outdoor temperature sensor to the terminals listed, and then that will get us going. Your other option at this point is to exempt from outdoor temperature sensing. Now, although it's required in heating applications, for temporary purposes, you can exempt, or if you're doing a combi boiler, you do not have to have an outdoor temperature sensor. So you could exempt at that point. So once you're through that A16 issue, again, when we go back and we first plug that boiler into a GFI on its own circuit, couple of things are going to display. So right now, as we take a look at the screen that I've got, I just have two blank lines. So I've got this boiler energized, it's plugged in, but it's turned off at the power switch. So if I come over here to the power switch, the Eco power switch, that's the one at the top right, and if I press that for 5 seconds, what we're going to actually do is bring the boiler back into its standby screen. Above that faucet are two buttons, plus and minus, and that is going to help us determine the output temperature in a combi boiler. So it will not determine the output temperature in a heat-only boiler with an indirect. You'd actually use the AquaStat on the indirect for that feature. But to change that up and down, let's just take a look at what our setting is. It's 131 degrees. That's the water that we would make going out to that system. It's adjustable from 104 to 131. Of course, you always want to have connected to this boiler a thermostatic mixing valve so that we wouldn't want to put 131 degrees of water at a faucet. That could certainly hurt someone, cause injury because of that high temperature. Down at the bottom of that screen, at the 6 o'clock position, underneath the display of temperature there, you see a little heat emitter. So that heat emitter is going to be sitting there in standby, but when you see waves on top of that heat emitter, it's telling me that we're making heat for that, for the central heating side of that. And the central heating temperatures, where do we have a set point right now? Right now it's set to make 170 degrees of water temperature. It's adjustable from 68 to 194. So you have a wide range of operating points. If you've got some low temp radiant, absolutely, this is an excellent opportunity for that boiler. Once we energize this boiler, another call that we often get is, how do I get it into the manual test mode? I need to do some combustion testing. We do combustion testing at the factory before it leaves, but always a good idea to double check those parameters for the area that you're located in. And if you're doing an LP conversion, absolutely, positively must do combustion testing. So to do the combustion test, it's a very simple way to force fire this boiler into high fire, and then a simple button setting will drive it to low fire. You want to go back up to high fire, it's another button setting. So let me show you how to do that. It's pretty easy. So to change that, we're going to go the central heating buttons, the two at the bottom here, and we're going to hold those together for 5 seconds. You've got that little line in there that's going to wiggle its way around. And then once it gets to that 00, the boiler's going to light up. We can hear that fan going. Once it lights up, it's going to show 100 on the display, and the burner is going to drive all the way up to the high fire. And then if I go and push the DHW negative button, that light, that flame is going to go all the way down to the low fire, and it'll stay there as long as you need it to. So you can operate between high and low fire while we're doing our combustion testing. To get back out of that forced fired rate, we're just going to go ahead and hold those two buttons together, the central heating buttons at the bottom, hold those together for 5 seconds, and that will take us out of the forced firing rate. So those are a couple of the features that are found in the Quick Start Guide. I hope this is helpful to you. If you have more questions, please feel free to reach out and give us a call at 800-654-2109. We have people standing by to help you. Pick the appropriate menu option. We can get you into tech service or warranty, customer service, or distributor support. So again, thank you very much. Have a great day.